Hello, very good morning to one and all. So in this video we are going to discuss about the basics input output programming for the 8051 microcontroller. So at first let's discuss the benefit of going for C programming. So if you take the any compilers that is going to produce the hex file, so that hex file we are going to download into the ROM space of the microcontroller. But always the size of the hex file is the primary concern. Why? Because generally microcontrollers will be having a very limited on-chip ROM, as well as the if you take a code space of the 8051, its code space was internal code space was only 4 kilobytes, and it can be expanded till the 64 kilobytes. If you take the primary advantages of the C programming is like it is easier to write. As well as it is less time consuming to write the C programming rather than compared to the assembly language. If you take a C programming, which is very easier to modify and update, as well as you can use the code available in the existing function libraries, as well as if you take a C code, which can be portable to other microcontroller with very little modification, or sometimes it can be used without any modifications as well. If you take C data types for the 8051 microcontroller, there are several data types are there, so which can be helpful for the programmers to create a smaller hex files. So that is completely based on the data type that has been declared in our programming part. So at first, if you take a very important data type is like unsigned character, and then we do have the signed character, we have the unsigned integer, we have the signed integer, and we have the S bit data type, we have the bit type, and we have the special function registers. So we will be seeing one by one. Provided if you take a S bit keyword, which allows the access to single bit of the special function registers. What is the meaning of a special function register? It can be accessed either by their names or by their address. If you take a bit data type, which allows the user to access the single bit of a bit addressable memory spaces, it is in the range of 20 to 2FH. So at first let's discuss what is the meaning of a character data type in the 8051. So the character data type is a basic choice for the 8051 based programmer. Why? Because 8051 is basically an 8-bit microcontroller. So most of the times we'll be making use of a character data type. And if you go for the unsigned character, which is of a 8-bit data type, which is in the range of 0 to 255, or in hexadecimal, which can be represented as 00 to FF. So if the C compiler is using the signed character as a default, if you fail to mention the keyword unsigned in the data type declaration. So if you go for the signed character is an 8-bit data type. Whereas the D7th bit is used to represent the negative or positive sign. And again, so that if a D7th bit is going to represent the signed value representation, thereby, so which can give us the values from -128 to +127. And again, where exactly we will be making use of the signed character representation and all? It is for example temperature measurement or temperature monitoring applications and all, we will be making use of the signed character representation. On the other hand, if you take means, we do have the unsigned integer and signed integer data types. So here, if you take means, if you see the unsigned integer is a 16-bit data types, which takes a value in the range of 0 to 65,535, and again, which is used to define the 16-bit variables such as memory addresses. And again, it is mostly used to count the values which is of more than 256. If it is less than 256, means you can go for the unsigned character. So if you want to count more than the 256, you can go for the unsigned integer. And again, since the registers and memory access are in the 8-bit chunks, the misuse of int variables will result in the larger hex file. So in case if you are having a 8-bit access, for that purpose, if you are declaring the unsigned integer data type, means it will be so the end will be resulting with a larger X file. Whereas in case of the signed integer, the signed integer is a 16-bit data type, whereas the D15th bit is used to represent the negative or a positive sign. Therefore, we have the 15 bits for the magnitude representation, which is in the range of -32768 to +32767. And again, if you see the next bit addresses, if you take many of the microprocessors, which allows the program to access the registers and I/O ports only in the byte, size. Whereas in many applications, we need to check the single bit as well. So in your 8051, we have the powerful feature, which is nothing but a single bit operation. So single bit instructions allows the programmer to set or clear or move or complement the individual bits of ports or memory or a register. And again, this bit addresses is possible which content is will be in the registers or in the RAM or in the I/O ports that are need to be a bit addressable, provided the content which is present in the ROM or holding a program code for execution is not a bit addressable one. If you take a bit addressable random access memory, so the bit addressable random access memory locations which in your 8051 are in the range of 20 to 2FH. So these 16 bytes provide us the 128 bits of RAM bit addressability. So which is nothing but 16 into 8, which is nothing but 128 bits. Okay, so 0 to 127 in decimal, or we can say it like 00 to 7F. So the last, the first byte of internal RAM location, which is nothing but a 20H, which has the bit address from 00 to 07. So the last byte of the last byte 2FH has the bit address to, where is the 2FH? Here it is a 2FH, which has the bit address from 78 to 7F. So the internal RAM locations 20 to 2FH are both byte addressable as well as the bit addressable. So these memory locations can be addressed either by means of a bit addressable also possible, or else byte addressable also possible for this addressing range. So if you take a bit addresses, so 00 to 7F belong to RAM byte address 20 to 2FH. So it can be 20 to 2FH also can be used for a byte addressing purposes. So we can use the single bit instructions, and these instructions uses only the direct addressing mode. So these single bit instructions can be accessed only by means of a direct addressing mode. So the next topic is like a special function registers and their addresses. So if you take your 8051, there are various special function registers that was given in the slide. So these special function registers can be accessed either by their names or by their addresses. So these special function registers have address between 80 to FFH. So note, if you take in this entire range, not all the address space from 80 to FFH can be used by the special function register. The unused location 80H to FFH are reserved and must not be used by the 8051 programmer. So these are all the available special function registers. These special function registers can be addressed either by their names or by their addresses. So the next point is single bit or a special function register data types. So if you take a single bit data type, so which can be processed by means of a SBit keyword. So SBit, my bit is equal to port 1 zeroth bit. So this SBit keyword allows the user to access the single bit of the special function register. So when you are declaring the SBit space, my bit is equal to port 2 fourth bit. So here if you observe carefully, so we have used the port 2 fourth bit format. So where X is nothing but a port 2, or it can be a port 0, port 1, port 2, or port 3, and Y here, this Y represent a it can be a 0 to 7th bit of that of the any specific port that has been declared in this S bit data type. So if you take the ports, as I told you, the ports can be of it can be of any port P0 to P3. So all these ports are bit addressable ports. So we can use the S bit data type to access any of the port P0 to P3. So if you take a S bit to access the byte size special function registers, we use the special function register data type. So here we are for the user to access the single bit of the special function registers, we are making use of a S bit. So if you want to declare the byte size special function register, we can directly declare a special function register port 0 is equal to 0x80. Why? Because we can able to port 0 also has it's a special function register. We can able to access the special function register either by their names or by their address. So 0x80 is the address for the port 0. So here we are accessing the port 0 through its address. So another way to access the special function register RAM space 82 FFH is to use the SFR data type. So here, as I told you already, here we are declaring the S bit, my bit is equal to 0x95 means we are trying to declare the address of the address through the 95 address. We are trying to enable the 95th address of the special function register which is there in the bit addressable memory range. So we can access the single bit of any special function register if we specify the bit address. So if you take a bit data type, so bit data type for the bit addressable random access memory can be declared by means of a bit keyword, RAM memory bit. So which is used to declare the bit addressable memory. So this data type allows the user to access the single bit of a bit addressable memory spaces, which is available in the range of 20 to 2FH, or we can say it like we use the bit data type to access the data in the bit addressable section of the data RAM space, again which is there in the range of 20 to 2FH. So these points are quite important in order to perform the input output programming, IO programming, or for the special function registers and the data type addressing towards the 8051 embedded C programming. These topics are highly important. So you try to refer to the textbook Mohammad Ali Masdi by 8051 microcontroller and embedded systems. So understanding these basic points will be enabling to continue in the demo, which I'm going to demonstrate through the Keel software. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you, and try to continue the remaining demos which I will be demonstrating in the Keel software. Please utilize these sessions. Thank you.